Hello, I am Mac, at least for a day, and everything's going to be okay. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the possibility that we're going to get a new expedition, the 10th expedition in No Man's Sky soon. But first of all, as you can see, I'm on an incredibly beautiful planet with purple snaker flies, green and fuchsia colored trees and fuchsia grass and bubbles. Oh my gosh. So I did not discover this planet. This planet was discovered by my friend Gwenny. And so during this video, I'm also going to be exploring her new base that she built here called The Nest. We'll see why it's called The Nest soon. But anyway, so we just had... I haven't gotten an update yet on PlayStation, but PC received an update, and maybe that's the only place the update's going to be, because... Okay, so No Man's Sky just launched on Mac, and it's kind of related to PC in that way, so I think that's why PC got an update, but PlayStation didn't, because it's not really related. But yeah, so now PlayStation can be played on pretty much all Mac devices, I guess, or a whole bunch of them that Sean listed. Okay, so, yeah, so Gwenny took my advice to finally use the slime base building part that you can get with tainted metal at Scrappers in Space Station. So basically this is like a new version of her mad scientist base, of course on a different planet, and I'm guessing she made a new one so that she wouldn't have to keep, because I think she reached the limit at the other base and she didn't want to have to delete stuff in order to add stuff to it. So anyway, this is pretty cool. I like this a lot. It's a lot more condensed. The other one was really big, but felt kind of empty. I mean, there was a lot of stuff in it, but there was a lot of empty space within it. But this looks a lot cooler because all of the stuff is condensed together and looks cool that way. Oh, nice. She's actually got a basement. It's a closed-in kind of basement, although there is windows, but... yeah, that's very cool. So anyway, No Man's Sky is on Apple devices now, and we didn't get any new features with this update. However, Sean Murray made it really clear that there is something else coming very soon. He put "very" in all caps. I mean, since it's not out yet, we don't know how soon it's coming. My pessimistic guess was what it might be a month before we get it, but other people are like, no way, it's going to be this week or next week or something. But as far as what it is, this is kind of a spoiler, I guess, because it was data mined. So if you don't want any spoiler for what is coming up and what is likely to be in the next update, this image I'm about to show was data mined. So that shows, it's a data mined image, and if you've done No Man's Sky expeditions before, you'll recognize it as the gold icons that we have for completing phases and maybe the final reward. You click them in your objectives log in order to get rewards and stuff. So that icon pretty much tells us that there is another expedition coming, and people on PC say that there's even like a expedition timer thing that the time hasn't been set to, and that pretty much clinches it that there is an expedition coming, because they've got expedition timers and stuff set up and whatnot. So we're almost definitely going to be getting an expedition, hopefully sooner rather than later. Like Sean said, it's going to be very soon. So now that image that I showed, couple things. There's actually a word there. It's not in an alphabet that we would normally recognize, but that the weird characters on it have been on other expeditions, of course. Like I said, those are the gold icons that we've had in other expeditions, and people have over time been able to translate the characters, figure out which letters of the alphabet they stand for based on what the objectives were called and what characters were on each of the objective things. This is really cool. I really like this. Sorry, I'm kind of jumping between topics here, but this is really cool. This looks a lot like abandoned or derelict freighters, and she's got it set up so that we got the capsules with the creatures, and then we got the slime, so it really looks like there was an outbreak here. This is what I was imagining when I was talking about, I hope that she would put this kind of thing in her bases. But yeah, this is really cool. Good job, Gwenny. So I was getting this. I was about to say, sorry, keep switching between topics. So the characters on that picture that I showed, they actually spell out the word crucible. Now, when I first heard that, I had a knee-jerk reaction. I was like, oh no, that probably means we're going to have permadeath, because the word crucible can mean a couple things. Crucible can mean like a trial or test that's really difficult. And so that made me think, oh no, that probably means the expedition is going to be a permadeath expedition. I really disliked the permadeath expedition that we had last year. I hope they don't do that again. I hope this one isn't permadeath. But the other definition of a crucible, and kind of the main definition of it, is, you know, a thing that you melt metal in order to like forge stuff. Like you melt molten metal in. You know what I'm talking about. It's like if you've watched the first Lord of the Rings movie, when they're making the ring, you see the little stone cup that has molten metal in it when it's forging the rings. That's a crucible. So yeah, it's something used in forging metal and stuff. And of course, what backs up that it's referring to that definition of the word is the picture. So the icon that was on that is what I call the autophage icon. That icon appears when you are directed to the new, they're kind of like scrap camps. It's a camp. It was added in the Interceptor update. It's a camp that basically has a space station core that has been taken out of a space station, or it's being built to be put in a space station. It's probably a scrapped space station core, probably, you know, supposedly taken from an abandoned space station. That's why abandoned space stations don't have cores, because they've been stolen and now they're at those camps that are found on planets. But anyway, that icon is the icon when you go to those places. And then there's also, you know, the new wrecked technology that has lore, and in that lore, I mean, the text refers to it as an autophage, and there's a lot of different lore you can get from those things. One in particular, well, I could go into the speculation, and maybe I will, of, oh man, those butterflies are really getting stuck up on the building. The lore and speculation of the autophage, well, this is what I think personally. A lot of people disagree on what the autophage are, or what that word even means. Autophage could be related to autophagy, which is a word in real life that refers to like cells being broken down so that they can be replaced in your body and whatnot. I don't think so. I think it's supposed to be a reference to Autobots from Transformers. So basically the autophage, I think, are another race of robots. We already have the Korvax, and One thing I don't agree with is some people think the autophage, or they think that those are just the remains of Korvax, but those technology remains don't look anything like Korvax. Korvax don't have giant hands that you often see in those wrecks. And I'll put a picture. I believe I have a screenshot of the thing I'm referring to so that I can show you what I'm talking to. So as you can see there, yeah, there's this robotic hand thing featured in these ruins that kind of tell us that the autophage were likely another robotic race, definitely different from the Korvax, despite what some people think. They seem to be related to the Sentinels. There is lore that's been around pretty much since the beginning that the Sentinels used to be loyal to the Atlas, and then when Korvax Prime was destroyed, the Sentinels basically went rogue and started attacking anyone who destroyed things on planets. So my theory is that before the Sentinels were the Sentinels, they were the autophage. They were a sentient race of robots that were loyal to the Atlas. And then, okay, so this gets into some really deep lore that is highly speculated, but okay, so when, okay, the Gek first spawn were an evil empire in ancient times, and they destroyed Korvax Prime. That lore has been around since the game began. But we now believe, based on new lore about the Abyss, that when Korvax Prime was destroyed, rather than being... Korvax Prime was basically a giant AI. It was a giant robotic planet with an AI sentience and everything. When it was destroyed, I think it basically broke up into pieces, what we now call nanites. Nanites are basically a currency in No Man's Sky, but they're also a big part of the lore where, they're like sentient little microchips, and they can give you visions when you hold them, and they can like drive you insane, and people take them as drugs, etc., etc. Nanites are like all kinds of crazy stuff in No Man's Sky. They can drive people mad. They exist in the water. They were used by the Korvax to reprogram the Gek to make them stop being an evil empire. Nanites are kind of insane. But I think nanites are the remains of Korvax Prime. When Korvax Prime was destroyed, the entire planet was blown up. They turned into these tiny nanites. And I don't think the Gek were able to melt them all down and use all of them. They were basically spread throughout the universe. And you can find nanites pretty much everywhere throughout the universe now. So basically, Korvax Prime became the Abyss, and the Abyss exists as the nanites spread throughout the universe. So it's not like a single place, it's not like a single thing, it's something kind of sinister and vengeful that exists throughout the universe. But anyway, Sentinels also have nanites in them. When you kill Sentinels and you open the canisters that they drop, they give you nanites. So what I think is that the autophage were the sentient race that existed before Korvax Prime was destroyed, and they were loyal to the Atlas. Then Korvax Prime was destroyed. The autophage were infected by nanites, and they became the hive-minded sentinels, the drones that basically have no free will. They're just kind of controlled. And I think the sentinels are being controlled by the Abyss. So basically, sentinels are getting revenge. They attack anyone who attacks planets. If you're mining resources on a planet, sentinels will attack you. And that's basically like they're programmed to try and prevent what happened to Korvax Prime. Korvax Prime was completely obliterated, and so anyone who harms a planet gets attacked by the Sentinels because they're trying to stop that from happening again. So it's basically the Abyss, or the Void, or whatever it's called. It's the leftover sentience of Corvax Prime controlling all the Sentinels to make them do its will, which is prevent planets from being damaged. And one thing that really backs this up is one piece of lore that you can get from the new autophage technology locations is it says a piteous hive mind. And some people said that, oh, that could be referring to the Corvax, you know, the autophage are actually the Corvax, and, you know, the Corvax are also a hive mind. They have the Corvax echoes, or no, it's the convergence, the Corvax convergence. And so people are thinking, oh, well, the autophage is what used to be the Corvax, and then they had the Corvax convergence. But no, I think they're talking about the Sentinel hive mind. The Sentinels have a hive mind because they're being controlled by the Void or the Abyss, which is previously Corvax Prime. And so those trashed autophage things are what's left of the race of the autophage, and it's lamenting that, you know, their race has become a piteous hive mind. The Sentinels are now just drones with no will of their own, and they're just being controlled by the nanites inside them that are programming to obey the Abyss's will. But that's my theory. So all of that because, you know, the icon for this expedition is what I call the autophage icon. So I'm hoping and I'm guessing that this expedition will center around the autophage, and I don't know, it might just be a long overdue expedition that, because we didn't get an expedition when we got the Interceptor update. It would have done well because we got a lot of cool new features in the Interceptor update, Sentinel ships, like I said, the campsites with the autophage and the different autophage tech that spread throughout the world. And there is some lore contained there, but it would have been nicer to have an expedition for that gives us more of a storyline about what all is going on there. So that's what I'm thinking, is that this expedition will be the autophage expedition. And about the crucible thing, some people in the community are speculating that we're going to get to build a robot, and that's why it's called crucible, because, you know, melting down metal and you're forging metal, and somehow that has to do with building a robot. I don't think so. I mean, we might do something with the autophage, maybe helping rebuild them. Probably not so that they can live again, but maybe just so that we can find out more lore from them. You know, probably something with, like, interfacing with the autophage camps, as I call them, and, like, you know, getting, like, actually talking to one of them and maybe getting some more lore there or something. I don't know. But I could be completely off base with all of this lore stuff, but based on different lore clues we've been getting, I think I'm fairly right about some of it. Obviously, I may be wrong about a lot of it as well, but anyway, this is going to be the 10th expedition, like I said. I'm pretty sure we are getting an expedition based on the stuff in the files I told you about. And it is 10th, so I'm guessing they want to do something really special for the 10th expedition. So, not that I want to get my hopes up too much, but I am kind of hoping that this will be a pretty cool expedition. And who knows, maybe we'll get it tomorrow. Probably not till next week at the earliest. But who knows, it could take them I'm pretty sure it won't actually be a month, because like I said, they already put an expedition timer thing on PC, and that pretty much means we're getting an expedition within a week or so. So, yeah, pretty sure we're going to get an expedition soon. Not sure what it's about, but I'm guessing it's going to have something to do with the new autophages, the new lore involving all that. And I really enjoyed Gwenny's base, really neat kind of mad scientist base with an outbreak of slime and stuff. Very well done, Gwenny. And I really love your your planet here that you've got, that you've discovered and you built the base on. But anyway, let me know what you think. If you think the if we're getting an expedition soon, and what you think the expedition is going to be about. But for now, I've been Mac. Thank you for joining me for a day. And remember, everything's going to be okay.